rich, and I ain't famous. I'm a fucking wild animal that cannot tame this. And I'm coming from my cut, bitch, I need that payment. Beginning to lack love, heart black as a raven. Sick of rap at the grave, and fuck the cap and you playing it. When my family get end up with you.
Welcome, everybody. So you know what time it is. It's time for another check, another reaction. Now, after the seriousness that was yesterday with Eminem's The Darkness and, you know, making a grown man fucking tear up, today, let's go a different route, hey? I told you yesterday that Eminem had just done a song with Juice WRLD, rest in peace, man. And I have heard the song. Everyone's heard the song. But let's listen to it together because it is bullshit. Like, insane. Insane. So, let's do that. Let's have a good time. Let's see why M's the GOAT. If you don't think he's the GOAT, then you're a potato. So, so let's do this. Godzilla, man. Eminem. Juice WRLD. Let's get it. Hippo gang, bitch.
You're a monster.
I can swallow a bottle of alcohol and I feel like Godzilla. Better hit the deck like the Cardilla. My whole squad's in here walking around the party, a cross between a zombie apocalypse and Bambita. Brain healing, which is probably the same reason I wrestle with mania shakies in this bitch. I'm posse up. Consider it to cross me. I've crossed the mistake if they sleep in on me. The hell's gonna get insomnia. ADHD hydroxyca. That's the posse. In AA with an AK melee, finna set it like a play date. Better vacate, retreat like a vacay mayday. This beat is cray cray ray J.
Like, say what you will about Juice WRLD, with his death, without his death, whether you thought he was a mumble rapper, whether you actually dove into what he could actually do and actually be shown how much of a fantastic freestyler this dude was. The dude was so young. And for Eminem to put him on a track on one of his own albums shows you that Eminem thought there was something really special about this guy. There's no denying it. You can go on YouTube and you can see Juice WRLD do a 1 hour freestyle. And it's not even, you know, you watch guys today on Sway and shit, and it's, they say it's a freestyle. It's not a freestyle. It's something that they've remembered. But Juice WRLD would be, like, given things, like a water bottle and shit, and he would rap about that. He actually, regardless of his drug use, regardless of what happened, he was a very, very talented artist. And that's why he's here. Let's get back into it.
Normal during the day, but at night turn to a monster. When the moon shines like Ice World truckers, I look like a villain out of those blockbusters. To the fire, spit a monster. Go on a dance on the Louis V carpet. Fire, but to the fire, monster. Go on a dance on the Louis V carpet.
I'm just a product of the cricket onyx. Told him make the balls, had him just appalled. Did so many things that pissed him off. It's impossible to list them all. And in the midst of all this, I'm in a mental hospital with a pistol ball. Trying to see what I'll still be like this tomorrow.
What was it? He's in a mental institution holding a crystal ball, asking it whether or not he's going to be there tomorrow at all. There's so much to this song. There's so many punchlines that it's like, it's so hard to keep up with it. And this isn't even him at his fastest. He's still yet to blow up. This is one of those songs, like I had mentioned in The Darkness yesterday. It's like a good movie. It's one of those songs that you're just going to keep coming back and coming back and coming back because you've got to catch a new punchline every single fucking time.
Back up against the wall, pencil drawn. This is just the song to go ballistic on. You just pull the pistol on the guy with the missile launcher. I'm just a Loch Ness, the mythological. Quick to tell a bitch you off like a fifth of vodka. When you twist the top of the bottle, I'm a monster.
You get in my way, I'ma feed you to the monster. I'm normal during the day, but at night turn to a monster. When the moon shines like Ice World truckers, I look like a villain that ain't on the block.
Fire, and I got no plans to
just said he's got no plans to retire. Good. Good. I will listen to this dude for the rest of my fucking life. And yes, there's the argument that, you know, Eminem is, though he is the GOAT, he is not everyday listening. And that's true. And that's not because of, you know, he doesn't... His music's not good enough to listen to every day. It's just that we're in fucking 2020, and there is so many good artists to listen to. And most of those artists are here because of this man. And if you don't agree, then hey, I could be wrong. But maybe you're wrong. You know, let's even just go. We're not going to get into all the doors that he opened up for all races to be successful in this genre. But he's also one of those legends that constantly releases new music. New music of a super high grade. There's legends now, like Snoop Dogg and shit, you know, forever a legend, you know, never going to go against anything. But their albums are not as good. Snoop Dogg's albums now are not as good as The Dogfather or Doggy Style. Snoop Dogg hasn't progressed. He hasn't bettered himself with every album. He hasn't bettered himself with the want or the need to be a rapper. Eminem still wants to be a rapper. Eminem still... He's like that little kid in Mensa. He's like a kid with an IQ of 200, and it doesn't matter what fucking diplomas he gets or whatever, he's still going to be learning. Eminem is still learning his craft. And that's why he can rap at the speeds that he does. That's why he can throw punchline on top of a double entendre on top of a punchline. That's why he can, like, morph words to sound different so it works with another word. That's why when people say no one comes, you know, Eminem has never dissed anybody worth his time. Regardless of your views on Benzino or cannabis or anything. Everyone's like, oh, he just disses pop stars and shit. You know why? Because real rappers don't want to diss him. That's why. You don't see legitimate rap stars go fuck Eminem. I'm gonna go for that. You know? MGK did it. Me personally. He's not a legitimate rapper. He may have been back before, but what he is doing now, he is not a rapper. Yeah, he had the balls to do it. Yeah, he said some cool stuff. But come on. And there's people out there that think MGK won. And we're not going to get into that neither. But legitimate rappers who have a skill set, ones that are considered the best, whether they're friends with, like, even ones who are friends with Eminem, if they really want it to be, you know, I'm not going to swear again, if they really want it to be the Potatoes, Tech N9ne, Royce the 5'9", King Crook, all these dudes, if they all want it to be dicks, they would go after Eminem, but they're not. Because they can't. And I'm sure there'll be comments, people disagreeing, but that's just how I calls it, how's it sees it. No one of any caliber goes for Eminem. Clout chasers go for Eminem. Nick Cannons go for Eminem. Even when he did Kamikaze, he dissed a bunch of people. Where the fuck is the diss track from Joe Budden? Where is it? Oh, he can't do one. Because the cunt hasn't fucking done anything decent in years. Let's see what else he's got, eh?
goes around comes around just like the blades on the chainsaw. Cause I caught the flag, but my dollar stacked right off the bat like a baseball. Like kidding, bitch, I got them rocks with so much ease that they call me Diddy. Cause I make bands and I call getting cheese a cakewalk. Bitch, I'm a player. I'm too motherfucking stingy for share. Won't even lend you an ear. Ain't even pretending to care. But I tell a bitch I'm Mary of Shabaria. Face of my genital area. The original Richard Ramirez, Christian Rivera. Cause my lyrics never sit well, so they wanna give me the chair. Like a paraplegic, and it's scary. Call it Harry Carey. Cause Harry.
They wanna give me the chair like I'm a paraplegic.
Time and Dick and Harry Carey and Mary and motherfucking dictionary. I'm swearing up and down. They can spit this shit's hilarious. It's time to put these bitches in the obituary column. We wouldn't see eye to eye with a staring problem. Get the shaft like a staring column.
We wouldn't see eye to eye with a staring problem. Like, where does he come up with this? No one is throwing punchlines. Man, the closest dude to ever throw quality punchlines, whether you like him now or not, whether he's fallen off, whatever, I don't give a fuck, is Lil Wayne. Lil Wayne was the king of punchline, man. But Eminem does a whole song where every single sentence is a punchline. And it all makes fucking sense. With flow, with delivery, with clarity.
Drink a happy pack, keep it as black ink. Evil half of the bad means evil. That means take a backseat. Take a back to fat beats with a maxi. Single look at my rap sheet. What attracts these people is my gangster bitch. Like a patchy with a catchy jiggle. I stack chips. You better got a half eat chill.
You ready? This is it. This is what I'm talking about. This is the reason why, right from this moment on, why nobody fucks with this dude. 1, 2, 3.
Fill him with the venom and eliminate him. Other words, I'm in him. I don't want to hurt him, but I did him in a fit of rage. I'm murdering again. Nobody will have been a fit of kill him. And double the fucking bodies in a lake. Obliterating everything is innovative. Renegade him. And I make anybody who want it with the pen and frame. Don't nobody want it, but they're going to get it anyway. I'm beginning to feel like I'm mentally ill. I'm going to tell a killer. Be killer. Be killer. Be the vanilla gorilla. You're bringing the killer within me out of me. You don't want to be the enemy of the demon who enemy. Being the receiving enemy. What stupidity it'd be. Every bit of me is the epitome of a spitter. When I'm in the vicinity, motherfucker, you better duck. And you finna be dead the minute you're an enemy. 100% of you is a fifth of a percent of me. A motherfucker finish you, bitch. I'm available. You want to battle? I'm available. I'm blowing up like an inflatable. I'm undebatable. I'm unavoidable. I'm unevadable. I'm on the toilet bowl. I got a trailer full of money, and I'm paid for. I'm not afraid of
man. Stop. Look what I'm planning.
Like, I couldn't even pause it because it's just too good. I can't do it. That, you know, when we heard Lucky You with Joyner on Kamikaze, you were like, fuck, man, that is fast. No, that was fast. Fucking hell. It's great to see him at his age still bettering himself. Like, at least what, he's like 47? He's nearly 50 years old. He's nearly 50 years old, man. Put that into perception. A nearly 50-year-old man can rap like that. I know 20-year-olds who fucking get puffed out walking up a set of stairs. It's insane. It's insane. And if he does another album next year, he's 48, then he's 49, and then he's 50. I look forward to the future of where he goes. Because this dude could rap till he's fucking 70 and still outdo everybody. But, you know, that's not the popular perception on the world of the internet. But that's my view. I'm the Bearded Hippo. Tell your mum, that was Godzilla. That was Juice WRLD. Rest in peace. And like, subscribe, share. Much love, guys. I'll be back very soon with another one. Peace.
I gotta do to get my foot in the fucking gate. I'm on a mission to individually decapitate you motherfuckers. Mad at me, all the moves that you can. I've been grinding, making new bands double time and shaking hands. And I'm probably the fucking chance that they won't take. I don't give a motherfucker my ambition, they won't break. Victory, they won't taste. Nah.